السلام عليكم.
So you guys had a heavy dinner. السلام عليكم. Thank you for joining us in this inauguration session. This is the session that will officially open the convention. My name is Munjad Ahmed. I'm one of the board members here at American Muslims for Palestine. I'm extremely, extremely honored to have all of you with us, inshallah, today. So let us start in the best possible way. So I'm going to call Sheikh Amin Shahada here to recite a few ayat from the Quran al-Karim.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا تحسبن الله غافلا عما يعمل الظالمون إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم وأفئدتهم هواء وأنذر الناس يوم يأتيهم العذاب فيقول الذين ظلموا ربنا أخرجنا إلى أجل قريب نجب دعوتك ونتبع الرسل أولم تكونوا أقسمتم من قبل ما لكم من زوال وسكنتم في مساكن الذين ظلموا أنفسهم وتبين لكم كيف فعلنا بهم وضربنا لكم الأمثال وقد مكروا مكرهم وعند الله مكرهم وإن كان مكرهم لتزول منه الجبال فلا تحسبن الله مخلف وعده رسله إن الله عزيز ذو انتقام يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار وترى المجرمين يومئذ مقرنين في الأصفاد سرابيلهم من قطران وتغشى وجوههم النار ليجزي الله كل نفس ما كسبت إن الله سريع الحساب هذا بلاغ للناس ولينذروا به وليعلموا أنما هو إله واحد وليذكر أولو الألباب صدق الله العظيم.
جزاكم الله خيرا.
جزاكم الله خير. When I think of this convention that we have this year, this is the 16th annual AMP convention. The theme of this year is Gaza's resilience. How appropriate. How honorable. We think of the brothers and sisters in Gaza and all of the calamities that they have gone through. We watched and we continue to watch bodies upon bodies being recovered from the rubble, some yet to be recovered. And we watch our brothers and sisters in Gaza and the level of iman that they have. And it's mesmerizing, it's amazing. And while we're watching their steadfastness, while we're watching their resolve, we realize that there are only two kind of people in this world. Those who stand for justice against genocide, those who stand for equality and freedom, those who stand for what's good and what's right. Oh, and then there's the other side. Those who stand for genocide, for killing, for hate, for inequality, for colonial settler imperialism, for fascism. And we say to those people who stand for that genocide, who are allowing the genocide to happen, including our own government officials, we say to them that we will not be silent. We will continue to fight this fight. We will continue until our mission is accomplished. And oh, by the way, our mission is not accomplished with a ceasefire. Our mission is accomplished when Palestine is entirely free. Our mission is accomplished when we all get to go to Masjid al-Aqsa and pray in a liberated Masjid al-Aqsa. That is when our mission is over. And we at AMP will continue to fight that fight. We take it as a badge of honor to continue this mission on your behalf. And inshallah ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from us our actions and help those people in Gaza and Palestine. So I thank you all for being here with us today for this 16th annual AMP convention. This is a testament to your caring. This is a testament to your resolve to continue also to fight for Palestine. AMP can't do it without you, and we can't do it alone. So we hope that you will continue to fight for Palestine after you leave this conference this weekend, inshallah. I'd like to call the convention chairman, Brother Salah Sarsour, to say a few words about this conference and to say a few words about his resolve in this matter. Jazakumullah khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome everyone. Ahlan wa sahlan bikum jami'an. In this 16th annual conference for Palestine, before I start, allow me please, on behalf of all of you, to express our condolences. عزاؤنا الشديد لا أخوة وأخوات بيننا الآن. Brothers and sisters among us, فقدوا أحبتهم في فلسطين، فقدوهم قريبا في غزة وفي الضفة، ولكن أصروا أن يأتوا إلى ها هنا ليكملوا المشوار كما كمل أهلهم في فلسطين. Brothers and sisters, they lost their loved one in Gaza and Palestine, but they decide to join us and to continue the journey, continue the struggle as their family, even in Gaza and West Bank, continues the struggle. You don't see this image everywhere. You just see this image with people of belief, people of honor, people of Palestine, that they know and they learn that the word give up, it's not in their dictionary. They know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory because they are the people of victory. And we know that. That's why they decide to make us silent, all of us. They decide to make us cancel the annual conference for Palestine. They decide to scare us. ولكن هيهات هيهات. With people like you, with the believers who believe in their cause, we will never be silent. And we can't be silent. That's why I am so honored that I have with me a steering committee and tens of volunteers and board of AMB that they decided, all of them, to continue the mission and to do what they have to do. They have to understand that we are not doing that mission for money, nor to put our name as celebrities, nor, and I will be honest with you, that we are good speakers. This is not our mission at all. Our mission to defend the people of Palestine. Our mission to support our people in Gaza and Palestine. Our mission to stand with Gaza. Our mission to see Al-Aqsa free and Palestine free. This is our mission that we understood. And we are teaching this to our children. And we are proud of this because this is justice. And as Munjid said before me, clearly, that now we are looking at people like two sides. People, they support genocides and ethnic cleansing. And people of values, people of khair, people of liberty. And this is what we want, and this is what our demand, inshallah ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, on behalf again of the steering committee, on behalf of all AMB volunteers, you see them everywhere, we welcome you. And we really appreciate all of you that you did the right thing. You should be proud of yourself that you left everything to come here to this site, Tinley Park, to be part of this continuous work for Palestine and for Gaza. You should be proud of yourself. And your children, one day, they will be proud of all of you for choosing the right thing for them. جزاكم الله خيراً. Also, I would like to thank all the speakers, moderators, people who join us to support this convention, relief organizations, vendors, supporters, donors, that they join the convention to make sure we will continue with this work and this mission. Again, جزاكم الله خيرا, بارك الله فيكم جميعا, and I hope you will enjoy this convention. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
جزاك الله خير, brother Salah. It takes a lot of work to put a convention like this on, and it takes a lot of dedicated people. One of the most dedicated people is our chapter host, Sister Ambassador Nidat Sahouri, who I asked to come up to say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm going to start with Tahiyya la Palestine. Tahiyyatan Filistiniyatan عطرة, تحية فلسطينية منتصرة, تحية لغزة العزة, غزة الصمود, غزة التضحية. سلام عليك يا غزة, وأنت تضمدين جراحك في هذه الهدنة, وأنت تجمعين أشلاءك. تقبل الله شهدائك وربط على قلوب التكلى والأرامل والأيتام ورفع عنك الظلم والبلاء عاجلا وليس آجلا, وما ذلك على الله بعزيز. أهلا وسهلا فيكم. I would like to all welcome all of you to our 16th annual convention on behalf of the Chicago chapter. My Chicago chapter has been working very, very hard. Who was at the Palestine Fest? We had the Palestine Fest October 2nd, and my team was working tirelessly for 3 months or so, and they needed a lot of rest, and then October 7 comes. And they've been, since then, no relaxation. They've been going on and on and on. So thank you, my team of Chicago. You know yourselves. If you're here, please stand up, because you really, really worked so hard, and we appreciate you. You know, the Zionists wanted, like Brother Salah said, the Zionists wanted to stop us, and Hyatt canceled us, and we struggled a little bit, and we were like, should we do it, should we not? And one time, we were like, okay, we're going to not do it, and we all said, no, no, we're not going to be defeated. We need to do it. We need to do it. And finally, we kept looking for like a week or 10 days, looking everywhere, all of us looking for places to find, and thank God we found this place thanks to Tinley Convention administration or leadership for having us here. We really thank you, because a lot of people canceled us. So this is really a blessing that we had this place. And at that time, we were trying to see, we have few members, we have few people who are registered. We were saying, okay, if we cancel, how are we gonna pay them back or refund them? We had maybe a few hundreds. Once we decided to go for it, our community, you guys, everyone here, mashallah, honestly, ترفع الراس, because the minute we said we're doing the conference, and I was getting messages, please do it anywhere you want, do it anywhere, even if it's one day, please do not stop it. We really, really need to do this conference, because if they want to silence us, please don't. So I was getting, oh, go to this place and go to that place. The minute we decided, 3 weeks ago, the first week we got 1,000 registers. The second week, another 1,000, and the third week, another 1,000. We came here 3,000 strong, other than the people who registered today. That never happened before. MashaAllah. So Gaza علمتنا أشياء كثير. Gaza جمعتنا. Gaza وحدتنا MashaAllah. So, يعطيكم العافية وأهلا وسهلا فيكم. You know, after September 11, our community thought, you know, we need to integrate with the society. We need to do things different. So, we started being more civically engaged. We started going to legislators. We trying vote. We started voting. We got out of the masajid. We will try to build our solidarity movement, and we're in churches here and there. We've been working, trying so hard, because we don't want what happened to us at September 11 to happen again. Until we thought we were doing great, until October 7 came, and the shock came with it. Who wasn't shocked? Who wasn't shocked when we saw Biden, that we had a million Muslim vote for him, just going to Israel and saying, we support you, and he did not see us. So we have been living in the last 2 months in the feeling of defeat, betrayal, unbelief. How could the world do this to us? We're betrayed by the whole world. A whole genocide is unfolding. And no one is doing anything about it. We thought 1948 and 1967 it happened, no one saw it. But now it's on social media and it's happening, and no one is doing anything about it. So what did we do? Palestinians, the best character about Palestinians is resilience. We are resilient people, mashallah. We have sumud. So we said, no, we're not going to be defeated. Let's go. We have been in the streets everywhere. We have been in the streets, we have been organizing, we have been doing direct actions, we have been in legislators' offices, we have been, calling them. Like I heard the other day, like legislators are getting 400 messages, 500 messages from us. So you guys are doing it, you guys are responding. And that's what's so beautiful about you. You guys are responding. One time we had a
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.